Good afternoon, Dr. Matthew. It's a great pleasure to have you here. I look back and look at you as the father of angioplasty, a mentor for many like us in angioplasty. So can you recapitulate those early moments of interventional cardiology in India with your trials and tribulations and now what you see in structural heart?
Thank you, Ajit. The question you raised is very relevant at this point of time when structural heart is also taking the active role into becoming a general mode of practice. We would consider that we were lucky. We went through a phase of time where the evolution was happening all over the world. We are in an era of development of newer innovations in cardiology. We are trying to replace the valve percutaneously. We are repairing the valve percutaneously, doing so many other congenital works. This is another evolution, what's happening, which is bound to happen. We are come to a second stage of evolution, and altogether we are able to achieve something for the betterment of our population, our people who deserves it.
Another encouraging thing this meeting has done is to bring cardiac surgeons and cardiologists and intensivists in one platform. So you think this heart team approach is not only now in structural but in most other areas of heart treatment, or do you think this is going to be restricted?
You're absolutely right, because today we realize it's not no more compartmentalized. We want to achieve something good for the patient, which has to be justified not only financially but ethically, and this is the way to go. And these meetings have put that emphasis on, and it was such an encouraging feature what we saw, lots and lots of surgeons getting directly involved with these meetings, and this is something very, very heartening and is very, very good for the country.
See, as a pioneer in angioplasty, we have taught many, many doctors, not only in India. I think now, in the next 10 years, personally, as a teacher, as a leader, as a mentor, as an innovator, what do you think you will be doing in the next 10 years for a cause such as structural heart disease?
See, structural heart disease has to have a different mindset than coronaries also. You have to have an explicit knowledge of echocardiography and explicit knowledge of radiology, interpretation of the CT, MRI, and after a certain age group, it would be very difficult to go back into each of those fields. For us, we can continue to do what we are doing right, what we know correctly, practice it. Doing a TAVR, doing a mitral clip is technically not a great challenge for us who has been doing this kind of innovative technology for last 30 years or 40 years. But still, I feel the youngsters have an edge over the next generation or our generation, because they can start concentrating on developing their skill level at the basics, starting from the echocardiography right up to the interpretation of the images in CT and MRI. That was the emphasis today, what we heard during the various deliberations and lectures. I feel the generation next will have an upper hand in using these devices more than us.
I would think that this, all we can do as this generation or your generation, is possibly handhold them into doing the right things, but I think they would possibly quickly get onto the bandwagon faster than many of us in this area and provide much better outcomes in this area of heart disease. Thank you, Dr. Matthew, for a very nice intro.
I fully agree with you, and that is what we should concentrate on, getting the next generation empowered to take on more and more challenging phases of development of cardiology. Thank you.